Hi everyone. Today we're going to review the basics of the SENT protocol. SENT, or Single Edge Nibble Transmission, is an automotive in-vehicle networking protocol used to report low-speed sensor data from a sensor to the engine control unit, or ECU. SENT was developed because the environment in a car was too noisy to transmit high-resolution sensor data vertically on a 5-volt bus. In SENT, sensor signals are transmitted as a series of pulses, where the transmitted data lies within the width of the pulses. Pulse widths are measured from falling edge to falling edge. The SENT physical layer consists of a 5-volt signal line and the ground. A level of less than 0.5 volts on the signal line represents a logic low, while greater than 4.1 volts is a logic high. Each SENT frame begins with a synchronization, or sync pulse, that is used to establish the tick time. The tick time, abbreviated as TT, is computed as the sync pulse length divided by 56. The data payload contains the actual information from the sensor. It can vary from 5 to 8 nibbles, with each nibble representing 4 bits of data. Each nibble starts with a logic low period of at least 5 ticks, followed by a logic high period representing the encoded value. 12 ticks for binary 0000, 13 ticks for binary 0001, and up to 27 ticks for binary 1111. The first nibble is a status and communication nibble that consists of 4 bits of additional information used by the CRC. Bit 0 is the start bit, bit 1 is the serial data bit, and bits 2 and bit 3 are optional slow channel data bits. The final nibble of the payload is always a CRC to confirm that the clocking is working correctly. Different CRC methods have been defined in each version of the specification. In the 2010 and 2016 SENT specifications, an optional pause pulse separates message frames. This concludes our video on understanding the basics of the SENT protocol. To learn more about SENT and SENT SPC, click the link to check out the other videos in our SENT series.